Yes, so we will start exactly from the point where we left in the previous class. So let me just quickly explain what we were doing. We were solving system of equations. And I told you that we had two possibilities for system of equations, homogeneous or non-homogeneous. So for homogeneous system, it's always consistent, and non-homogeneous system, it can have three possibilities: no solution, unique solution, and infinitely many solution. So we already have done examples for one for homogeneous system and one for non-homogeneous. So let me continue with it. So I'll just brief up. For homogeneous system, AX is equal to zero, so always has a solution. So now the information which I'm going to tell you is additional. Means if you don't even remember these points, you just apply the technique which I have told you to solve your system, you will eventually get the answer. It is not mandatory to remember these additional things, but this is just for information that if any time you have any doubt whether what you have obtained is right or not, so you can always match with it. So the first case is if n is equal to m, means your given coefficient matrix is a square matrix, right? The number of equations is same as the number of variables. So in that case, so this is common thing. Zero solution is always there for every system, be it rectangular matrix, be it square matrix. So the zero solution means x zero, y zero, z zero, whatever be the all variable zero, that solution always exists for every system. Now we are talking about non-trivial solution. So if it is a square matrix, in that case, the non-trivial solution exists if and only if determinant A is zero, right? Now how that is coming from where it is coming, if and only if determinant A is zero. So you look at this, if determinant A is non-zero, then the matrix is invertible, because this is the result we know from our 12th standard that under what conditions a square matrix is invertible, it should be non-singular. Non-singular means its determinant should be non-zero. So if determinant of coefficient matrix is non-zero, then A inverse will exist. So what you can do is multiply this equation with A inverse. So A inverse into A into X is A inverse into zero is zero, because on the right hand side, you will still have the zero vector. So this implies X is equal to zero, because A inverse into A will be identity into X is equal to zero. So identity matrix multiplied with any vector or any matrix will give you the same vector. So that means in this case, the only solution existing is the zero solution. So that is a unique solution. So that means for having non-trivial solution, non-trivial solution means infinitely many solutions you will have. So that you will have when determinant is zero. So the point is, this is additional information. Again, I'm telling you, you don't need to check this condition, but in case you want, so you can verify this for the examples. Like the example which we did last time, I will show you for homogeneous system. We had this example done, right? Okay, sorry, this was not a square matrix. So our that analogy cannot be used here. So let's just leave that. That information is just for the square matrices. So what is the second case? When n is greater than m. So that means you have more variables than equations. So in this case, you will always have infinitely many solutions. Okay, so this you can try, like the example which we did. You have four columns, three rows. You have more variables than equations. For homogeneous system, you will always have infinitely many solutions. And we have already done example for the same. And the third case is n is less than m. So that means you have more equations than variables. In this case, you may have solution or you may not have solution. So means this case is very rarely arising. These kind of examples are very rare. These are over-determined system. So in this case, you may not have, most of the times you will not have infinitely many solutions. So no non-trivial solution. So these kind of example you will find very rare when you have more equations than variables. So that's all about homogeneous system. Now let's go to non-homogeneous system. So for non-homogeneous system, I already told you we have three possibilities. First is if the rank of A is same as rank of augmented matrix. If the rank of A is same as rank of augmented matrix and that rank is same as N. What is N? The number of variables in your system. In that case, you have unique solution. So we already have done example for the same last time. And in second case, when rank of A is same as rank of augmented matrix B, but this is less than N, in this case, you will have infinitely many solutions. And for third case, when rank of A is not equal to rank of B, you will have no solution. So let's do one more question for this case and then we will advance forward. You can look back again in the notes once the lecture is finished. So right now, please don't request me to scroll up or scroll down because just understand it. You can read and understand it in detail later on. Right? Yes. So let me just give you an example of this case when you have infinitely many solutions in a non-homogeneous system. You will have these examples in your tutorial sheet as well. But let me just give you an example. I have it here. 4x minus 2y plus 6z is 8. X plus y minus 3z is minus 1. 15x minus 3y plus 9z is 21. So you know the procedure. You have to construct augmented matrix. 4 minus 2, 6, 8. 1, 1 minus 3 minus 1. 15 minus 3, 9, 21. So this is augmented matrix. I am directly writing the row reduced echelon form because by this time everybody should be knowing how to convert a given matrix to row reduced echelon form. So you just apply your row operations and convert into row reduced echelon form. So I will be getting this matrix is equivalent to 1 0 0 1 0 1 minus 3 minus 2 and 0 0 0 0. So this will be the final row reduced echelon form of the augmented matrix. Now, let me see in which category it falls. So what is rank of A? So up to this point, the first three columns that was of the coefficient matrix. So looking at only this matrix, if I count the number of non-zero rows, the number of non-zero rows is the rank. So how many rows are non-zero? Two, first and second. So the rank of A is 2. And what is the rank of a augmented matrix? So for that, I have to look at the complete matrix, including the fourth column. So then count the number of non-zero rows. So that is also 2 because the last row happens to be completely 0. So the rank of both A and AB is same. So that means it is in this category because rank is equal, but less than N. 2 is less than 3. What is 3? 3 is the number of variables, right? Your N is 3. So that's why in this case, we will have infinitely many solutions. So this is the answer. And now answer is means we have to write what are those infinitely many solutions. Okay, so for that, the process you already know, you just transfer it back to the equation language. So writing in equation form again, you will get what is the interpretation coming from first equation. X is equal to 1 because the fourth column is always going to represent the right hand side. So it is these values 1 minus 2, these will always come to the right hand side of the equality sign, and left hand side will give you the parameters, the variables. Like this is column of x, this is column of y, this is column of z. So it's easy to read. 1 into x plus 0 into y plus 0 into z. And it will be always in this form because these will always be 0. So this is x is equal to 1. Right. Similarly, you read the second equation. The second equation is 0 into x, 1 into y, minus 3 into z. So y minus 3z and right hand side is minus 2. So you get this. And from third equation, you will not get any meaningful information because the third equation will simply give you 0 into x plus 0 into y plus 0 into z is equal to 0. So that is not going to give me any valuable information. So no need to write that. So the all zero rows need not be even read. Just read the non-zero rows and write them in the equation form. And from here, you get your solutions. So x is having value 1 and y's value is in terms of z. And where is the value of z? Since no restriction is coming on the value of z, so that means z can have any value, right? So z is a free variable here. So it's always, you can always find how many variables will be free variables. So the difference between this 2 and 3, if the rank was turning out to be 2 and that was less than the number of variables 3, so 3 minus 2 is 1. So this is always going to be the number of free variables, that these many variables out of your system will be arbitrary and rest of the variables will be in terms of that variable. So we have one free variable, which is z, y is in terms of z, and x is having a constant value 1. So the solutions are 1 minus 2 plus 3 alpha comma alpha, where alpha is arbitrary, can have any real value, right? So these are how many solutions? Infinitely many, because you give me one value of alpha, that will be one solution. You give me another value of alpha, that will be another solution. So you can give me as whatever value, so I will give you a new solution. So that's why we say this is the set of infinitely many solutions, but this is how it is written in general. It, you seem like you're writing one solution, but this is a combination of infinitely many solutions, right? Yes, Ishan, you are asking if we write z in terms of y, then y will be free variable. Perfectly well, you can always do that. One of them will be free. Either you write y in terms of z, or you write y in terms of, or z in terms of y. Right? So this is about the non-homogeneous system. And this example we have done. So two examples for non-homogeneous we have done. Unique solution and infinitely many solutions. So in your tute sheet, you will find the third case when you will have no solution. So I am giving you one more example, but that's a little bit twisted question. There you will get to know that when this kind of situation will happen, that what will happen when rank of A will not be same as rank of augmented matrix B. So to look at that, let me give you the next question. Okay. So these kind of questions also you will find in your book and in your tutorial sheet. So this says that this is actually reverse question. Determine all values of k for which the given system has no solution, infinitely many solutions, and third case is unique solution. So all the three possibilities now together will be explored in this question. What is a given system? X plus ky is 2, 2 minus k times x plus y is 3. So just for simplicity, I have taken the example of a 2 cross 2 system, but you can also have the similar kind of examples for 3 cross 3 or 4 cross 4 systems. The examples are there in the book and the tutorial sheet. So let me just do this one. So this is a non-homogeneous system. As you can see, the right-hand side is non-zero. So let me construct the augmented matrix. 1, k, 2. 2 minus k 1, 3. So the only difference between this question and the earlier discussed questions is here we are having already the involvement of an arbitrary value. So this is a reverse question that we are supposed to find for what value of k this system is going to fall into known solution category, infinitely many solution category, or unique solution category. So you just need to go with the procedure. So you convert this into RREF just by treating k as a number into the system. Do not give a value to k from yourself, just do the calculation. So to convert into row reduced echelon form, this one will remain one, obviously. This will be, what row operation will be used? R2 changes to R2 minus 2 minus k times R1, because I have to do the subtraction so that this becomes 0. So it will be 2 minus k times, you have to multiply with first row and then subtract from second row. So this will be 1 minus 2 k has to be multiplied with 2 minus k. So 1 minus 2 k plus k square. So 1 minus 2 k plus k square. And this is 3 minus 2 into 2 minus k. So that is 3 minus 4 plus 2 k. So that is minus 1 plus 2 k. So let's do one more step to convert it into RREF. This entry, I have to make 1, and then I have to make it 1 and using that make it 0. But we can still answer the given question without converting into RREF, right? Only this much conversion is sufficient. I will show you how. Because in these kind of questions, this will be a better technique, that you don't need to convert to the final RREF. Means you need not make it 1 here so that calculations will become difficult. You need to divide by this bigger quantity, right? 1 minus 2k plus k square. So I will tell you without converting into RREF, that just make this entry 0. Means just try to make it this kind of matrix. Which kind? This is upper triangular. Okay. In RREF, we have a diagonal matrix, because here is also 0, here is also 0. We try to create zeros in every column above and below the leading term. So RREF, we have the diagonal matrix. But in this question, it's okay if you just convert into upper triangle, right? So yeah, let me now come to the first part. When does this system is going to have no solution? So for this system to have no solution, rank of A should not be same as rank of augmented matrix B, right? So now you will say, since we do not know the value of K, how we are supposed to know the value of the rank? So when this situation is arising, now what are the possibilities? If these are not equal, what can be the rank? Okay, so what are the possibilities there? So this is only going to possible when rank of A is going to be 1, while rank of augmented matrix is going to be 2. So you are already clear on this. We cannot have a rank 3 because the number of rows is just 2. So the row rank, the rank is always less than equal to the size of the matrix. So if you have a 2 cross 2 system, you cannot have rank greater than 2. If you have a 3 cross 4 system, you cannot have rank greater than 3. So it's always, the rank is always less than equal to the minimum of. Like if you have a M cross N matrix, then rank of A is always less than equals to minimum of M and N. So this is a, if you look at only A, it's a 2 cross 2 matrix. So its rank cannot be greater than 2. And if you look at augmented matrix, it's a 2 cross 3 matrix. So still the rank is less than equals to 2. So both ranks cannot be equal to 2 because we want them to be not equal. So these are the possibilities. Rank of A will be 1 and rank of AB is equal to 2. The other possibility is not there. Rank of A is 2 and rank of augmented matrix is 1. This is not possible. Yes. Please think about this point. Why this is not possible? The point which I have just written. Why this possibility is not there, that you will have A as rank 2 and rank of augmented matrix as 1. Is it possible? Yes, because in case you will try to make rank of A2, in case you try to make rank of A2, that means both of these rows will be non-zero. So that means this entry in that case will be non-zero. So if this entry is non-zero, so that will make this row, the complete row will be counted as a non-zero row. So in that case, even if this entry becomes zero, the augmented matrix will still have rank 2. I hope you're getting this point. If this entry remains non-zero, what will happen in that case? Both of the matrices will have the same rank, which is equal to 2. Because if this is non-zero, so the number of non-zero rows in this portion is 2, and the number of non-zero rows in this complete matrix is also 2. So in that case, rank will be equal, okay? So that means when you are trying to make rank of A is 2, in that case, augmented matrix will also have rank 2. So this case is not possible. So that means the only possibility for no solution is going to happen when rank of A is 1 and rank of augmented matrix is 2, right? Right now, we are not talking about zero rank. We'll come to that. We will come to that. Zero rank means there is no non-zero row. Some of you are writing in your answer that rank can be zero also. I tell you the rank can be zero only for a zero matrix. Because for rank to be zero, every row of the matrix should be zero. So that's an extreme case not going to happen here. We do not have a zero matrix here. So there is no possibility of rank to be zero. So this is the only possibility for the ranks to be not equal. Is it clear up to here? Is it clear up to here, this point? Right, so now, what do you further need for rank of A is 1? For rank of A is 1, look at just A. A is 1k, 0, 1 minus 2k plus k squared. This is just the part of A. So that means the second row should be 0 row. Only then rank of A is going to be 1. And for this row to be 0 row, this entry has to be 0. And this entry has to be 0 means 1 minus 2k plus k square is 0, which is nothing but k minus 1 whole square, and which is nothing but k is equal to 1. The same values means it has two roots, but both roots are same. So k is equal to 1 is the value for which rank of A is equal to 1. And look at the other entry in the last column. In the last column, the entry is minus 1 to plus 2k. So if you put k is equal to 1 here, so this will be minus 1 plus 2, which will be plus 1, which is non-zero. So that means we got our answer. When we put k is equal to 1, in that case, rank of A is going to be 1 because this becomes 0. But rank of augmented matrix remains 2 because this remains non-zero. Because in that case, this entry, the third entry becomes non-zero. So when you count the number of non-zero rows in the augmented matrix, that will turn out to be 2 because this and this both are non-zero rows. So that's about the first case. So that means k is equal to 1 gives us no solution. Please ask if you have any doubts till that this point. Otherwise, let me finish the question, then I will take your doubts, right? So for no solution, we got k is equal to 1. So let's again look at the matrix and answer when our system is going to have infinitely many solutions. So for infinitely many solutions, what is the condition? That rank should be same, but that should be less than the number of columns, the number of variables. And then there are two variables in the system, as you can see. So both of ranks should be same, A and augmented matrix, but that should be less than 2. So that means that is possible when both of these ranks are equal to individually 1. Both should be 1 because less than 2, the only number present is 1. Again, telling you zero rank possibility is not present in this example. So the rank should be 1. Now, what do you mean by rank should be 1? So in this case, what should happen for rank to be 1? So the number of non-zero rows in both the matrices A as well as augmented matrix, the number of non-zero rows should be just one. So that means both of these numbers, this one and this one, if both of these become zero simultaneously means with the same value of k, if both of them become zero simultaneously, then only we are going to have the rank of A is same as rank of augmented matrix is same as one. Okay, both of them should become zero. Now, is it possible? Again, a question. Can both of these entries be zero simultaneously? Is there any value of k which makes them zero, which makes both of them zero? This is going to become zero at k is equal to half. This is going to become zero at k is equal to one. So clearly there are two different values. So that means there is no value of k which will make both of them zero simultaneously. Hence, this case of infinitely many solutions is not possible in this example, right? So we are trying to explore the possibilities. So we will now write no value of k would give 1 minus 2k plus k square is 0 and 2k minus 1 is 0. Remember, the important word is simultaneously. They both of them should be 0 at the same time for set value of k, which is not possible. So that's why this case is not possible. What is the third case? The third case is unique solution. So for that, we know the condition is rank of A should be same as, and that should be same as 2. So for that, what we want, that this 1 minus 2k plus k square, that should also remain non-zero, right? Because if this will, there's no other condition. Because if this quantity remains non-zero, this will make both of the ranks equals to 2. The same point I've explained here while explaining you the no solution case, right? That 1 minus 2k plus k square non-zero will give both of the matrices rank 2. So when it is non-zero, so k is not equals to 1, because this is becoming 0 only for k is equal to 1. So k is not equals to 1 is the condition for unique solution. So there are all the values. If any value of k you give to the system except 1, the system is going to have a unique solution. If you give k is equal to 1, the system is going to have no solution. And for no value of k, the system is going to have infinitely many solutions. So that is the answer complete about this particular question. Yes, so now you can ask if you have any doubt in this particular question, because this should be very clear how to use these conditions, because the same thing you have to do for a 3x3 system or a 4x4 system. You should be very clear about how to combine the two conditions of rank. Vidushi, to answer again, the rank 1 is 0, the rank 0 is possible only for a 0 matrix. If the all the rows of the matrix become 0 only, then the rank is going to be 0. And in some textbooks, you will even find the rank is undefined. So that's a trivial, extreme case. Those kind of examples are useless to us if the coefficient matrix is 0, all 0 becoming 0. So that is not going to happen in any practical example. Yes, Uday.
मैम, ये k not equal to 1 पे मैम unique solution नहीं हो रहा मैम, लेकिन अगर k equal to 1 मैम k equal to 1 करते हैं तो मैम ये वाला 1 minus 2k plus k square तो 0 हो जाएगा, लेकिन 2k minus 1 तो non-zero रहेगा, तो फिर मैम 2 rank हो जाएगा, तो मैम वो उस पे भी unique solution हो रहा है.
No solution होगा ना, क्योंकि augmented matrix का rank तो 2 होगा उस केस में. But coefficient matrix, I'll give you example. आप k की मुझे value दे दो, कौन सी वन?
Okay, मैं ऐसा
है ना, आप k को यहाँ पे one substitute करके देखो, तो क्या बनता है आपका system? 1 1 2 1 1 3, right? If you put k is equal to 1, okay? So yes. इसको अगर आप row reduced करते हो 1 1 2 0 1 3, एक step और कर लो, so you will get 1 0 1 0, this will be 3 minus 2 one, right? So sorry, something is wrong here. Is this your system, right?
सीधा फॉर्मूले वाले में डाल लेते हैं नीचे।
हाँ वहां से भी कर सकते हैं, एक मिनट लेट मी सी देयर इज सम मिस्टेक। व्हाट वी डिड, वी पुट k इज इक्वल्स टू 1, राइट? We are saying k is equal to 1 will give us no solution to this. Okay, sorry, this is 1, 1, 3. So when you subtract this 1, no, sorry, यहाँ पे भी 0 आएगा, मैंने गलती कर दी। जब आप इसको row reduce करोगे transfer, so 1 minus 1, 0, 1 minus 1, 0, 3 minus 2, 1. This will be this difference. Right? Now you try to read the solution. What is the second equation telling you? The second equation is telling you 0 into x plus 0 into y is equal to 1. Ye right hand side hai, right? So 0 into x plus 0 into y is 1. So 0 is equal to 1. Not possible. So this is always happen in the no solution case. Jo aapke no solution ke examples aayenge unme yahi hoga ki augmented matrix mein to last row puri zero ban jayegi, but jab aap as a complete matrix usko dekhoge yahan pe non zero entry present hogi, to us case mein aapka contradiction aa jayega ki left hand side is all zero but right hand side pe non zero number present hai. Agar right hand side mein bhi zero hota tab infinitely many solutions banenge, but agar left hand side pe zero ban gaya aur right hand side pe aapke paas kya hai non-zero number, in that case you will always have no solution. So what I am trying to conclude is, आपको ये सब कुछ याद रखने की जरूरत नहीं है, you just go with the process कि हमें row reduced echelon form में convert करना है और last में जाके हमें इसको ऐसे read करना है equation language में, automatically जो भी answer आना होगा अपने आप आ जाएगा. ये सिर्फ additional conditions हैं इस तरह के questions को करने के लिए. So you just practice working on how to transform to RREF. Is it clear now?
Yes, ma'am. Ma'am, इस वाले में हमने इसको row reduced echelon form में नहीं convert किया था, ma'am. लेकिन फिर भी rank निकाल लिया. मैं मतलब किसी normal matrix के भी निकाल सकते हैं.
हाँ हाँ हाँ. Actually वो theoretically होता है. वो हम आपको उसको diagonal में ही convert करना सिखाते हैं, because उस case में solution read करना बहुत आसान होता है. X की value सीधा आ जाती है, Y की सीधा. यहाँ पे X है, यहाँ पे Y. This is 1, 1, 1. So 1 into X सीधा जो भी राइट हैंड साइड पे लिखा होगा. सो इट्स रीडिंग सॉल्यूशन इज इजी इन डायगोनल फॉर्म. एक्स इज दिस, वाई इज दिस, जेड इज दिस. अपर ट्रायंगुलर में सॉल्यूशन रीड करना डायरेक्ट नहीं होता है, उसमें पहले आप लास्ट वेरिएबल रीड करते हो, फिर आप सेकंड लास्ट इक्वेशन बनाते हो. दैट्स व्हाई ये वाला प्रोसेस हमने आपको नहीं कराया है. वी हैव ऑलवेज आस्क्ड यू टू कन्वर्ट इनटू डायगोनल फॉर्म, सो दैट इज बेटर. बट यस, ये भी आप कर सकते हो रैंक फाइंड करने के लिए. अगर आप सिर्फ डायगोनल एंट्रीज के नीचे, मीन्स इसको एक अपर ट्रायंगुलर मैट्रिक्स में कन्वर्ट कर लो एंड देन यू काउंट द नंबर ऑफ नॉन जीरो रोज, दैट वे आल्सो यू विल गेट द रैंक. क्योंकि इस क्वेश्चन में हमें रैंक ही फाइंड करना था, मीन्स रैंक के कंपैरिजन से ही आंसर निकालने थे, इसलिए मैंने उसको नहीं कन्वर्ट किया. बट अदरवाइज अगेन नो प्रॉब्लम, आप एक स्टेप और कर सकते हो, इस के को जीरो बना सकते हो. दिस विल बी इन टू आर आर ई एफ. लेट मी जस्ट डू दैट स्टेप, वो भी हमें करना है लास्ट में. एक छोटा सा स्टेप रहता है हमारे क्वेश्चन का. लेट मी फिनिश दैट. यस, यूनिक सॉल्यूशन. नाउ वी आर सेइंग के नॉट इक्वल्स टू 1 इज यूनिक सॉल्यूशन. नाउ व्हाट इज दैट सॉल्यूशन, वो सॉल्यूशन है क्या? तो वो सॉल्यूशन निकालने के लिए वी विल लुक एट द मैट्रिक्स अगेन. 1k 2 0, 1 minus k होल स्क्वायर इज देयर एंड दिस इज 2k minus 1. सो यू कैन डू वन मोर स्टेप टू कन्वर्ट इट इन टू आर आर ई एफ. अदरवाइज आप डायरेक्टली इसको इक्वेशन में ट्रांसफर करके भी रीड कर सकते हो. सो टू कन्वर्ट इन टू आर आर ई एफ फॉर्म, आई नीड टू डिवाइड विद 1 minus k होल स्क्वायर, राइट? एंड देन आई नीड टू मेक दिस 0. सो दिस इज k times, you have to multiply the second row so that this becomes 0. So this is 2 minus k times 2k minus 1 over 1 minus k square, and this is 2k minus 1 over 1 minus k whole square. So this is the final RREF form. आप ये पहले भी कर सकते थे, right? So from there you could compare, but I found that calculation easier and conclusive, more conclusive. So that's why मैंने वहीं से कर लिया था. अब आपका सॉल्यूशन रीड करना आसान है, बिकॉज दिस साइड यू हैव कन्वर्टेड इनटू आइडेंटिटी. Okay, so now you can see here, this identity creation has been possible only because you are dividing with 1 minus k. So we are dividing with 1 minus k. So that means we are already with this assumption that k is not equals to 1. So from here also you can say the unique solution is getting possible only when the denominator is non-zero, only then it is defined. Okay, so what is the solution? This is simply x value, this is simply y value. So x is 2 minus k, 2k minus 1, 1 minus k whole square. And what is y? Y is 2k minus 1, 1 minus k whole square. So that is a unique solution. Whatever value of k you put, you will get your answer from here. So that completes this particular question. And let me just now go ahead with the one more concept in the continuation of this echelon form using row operations. So this kind of question also you might have done already. Find the inverse of a matrix using row operations. So you will be given a matrix and you are supposed to find its inverse. So we already have seen this result or remark I made in the last lecture, that every non-singular matrix row reduced echelon form is going to be identity matrix. So the same concept we are going to use here. So you are given a matrix, say, let me just directly start with an example, 2 0 1 7 1 2 3 minus 1 1. So how to find its inverse? So you form the augmented matrix. But in this case, there is no right hand side. We are not solving the system of equations. This question is simply finding the inverse of a matrix. So you have to augment with the identity matrix of which order? 3 order, because this is going to be always a square matrix. Only then you are asked to find the inverse of it. It cannot be a rectangular matrix. So I3, you will augment it with 2, 0, 1, 7, 1, 2, 3, minus 1, 1. And so this side you have 1, 0, 0, 0, 1, 0, 0, 0, 1. So all what you have to do here is to apply row operations to get row reduced echelon form. So on this side, after applying row operations, you will get it in this form. The left hand side means the first 3 columns, they will be converted to identity. So you will be only focusing on first 3 columns. You have to convert that into identity. They are convertible to identity. Why? Because we know already the matrix is invertible. Okay. So the first 3 columns should be converted to I3, 3x3 identity matrix. While doing that, in the process of making them identity, you will choose some row operations, and those row operations will automatically, what they will do? They will convert this right hand side into a new matrix, and that new matrix will be A inverse, right? So I'm not going to solve this question for you. You solve it completely yourself. I'm going to just tell you final answer, which you will get after applying the row operations. So the first 3 columns will be identity, and they will be automatically changed to certain values. So you just read your matrix inverse from there. So this tells us this is A inverse, minus 3 by 4, 1 by 4, 1 by 4, 1 by 4, 1 by 4, minus 3 by 4, right? So these kind of questions are also there. The same technique is applicable if you have a 2x2, 4x4 matrix and so on. You just have to augment it with the same order identity matrix, get RREF form, and read then the last 3 or 4, whatever be the number of columns, and that is your A inverse. So this is also a technique. Again, you might ask that we already know how to find the inverse of a matrix, then why we need to learn this approach? Again, from computational point of view, computing the inverse of a matrix by doing this cost less in the number of operations. The number of operations in doing this procedure is less than the number of operations which we usually do. You know, how do we find inverse? We find the adjoint. For finding adjoint, we find the cofactors, we compute those small determinants and compute the total determinant of the matrix. So all those operations in combined are computationally expensive than this one. So that's why most of the computers rely on this process of finding the inverse of matrices rather than the other one. So you need to learn this technique as well. Right, so that's all about the system of equations and the row reduced echelon form, rank, and the row operations. Next lecture, we will be able to start with the next topic of the same unit, linear algebra. Yeah, I also need to tell you the book. Maybe I just forgot to tell you the book last time. So the book we are following for linear algebra is Krishnamurti. This is the title. These are the three authors, Krishnamurti, Mendra, Arora, and Introduction to Linear Algebra. This is the title of the book. So these are all information is also there on the LMS page. You can find from there. But otherwise, it's just if you just do the class notes and practice questions from whichever book. You can, for practicing questions, you can follow some other books also. They are in Jan Anger Jan also, this topic. They are in Krasik also. So you just need to find the particular chapters and do their exercises. So I won't be able to start with the new topic. We do have time. You can ask me your any doubts regarding this. Because I don't want you to be confused about anything.
हम x और y को मैम तो हमने k की फॉर्म में मैम पिछले ऊपर लिख दिया था मैम उसके अंदर हम k की कंडीशन निकालने के लिए s मैम यूनिक सॉल्यूशन में x नॉट इक्वल टू y करके k की वैल्यू निकालेंगे
कैसे सॉरी आई डिडंट गेट योर क्वेश्चन
मैम जैसे x और y की वैल्यू हमने k में निकाल ली अब हमें यूनिक सॉल्यूशन चाहिए तो उसके लिए मैम x नॉट इक्वल टू y करके 2 माइनस k जो राइट साइड है उन दोनों का नॉट इक्वल टू करके k की वैल्यू निकालेंगे
नहीं नहीं k की वैल्यू नहीं निकालनी हमें ये पूछा गया था कि k की कौन सी वैल्यू के लिए ये सिस्टम ऑफ इक्वेशंस का यूनिक सॉल्यूशन होगा तो वो वैल्यू हम निकाल चुके हैं वैल्यू मींस कंडीशन निकालनी थी कंडीशन ये आई है कि जब भी k नॉट इक्वल्स टू 1 होगा तो कुछ भी हो मींस 2 हो 3 हो 1/2 हो माइनस हाफ हो व्हाटएवर एनीथिंग अदर एनी रियल नंबर अदर देन प्लस 1 जब भी k की वो वैल्यू होगी इन दैट केस दिस सिस्टम इज ऑलवेज गोइंग टू हैव यूनिक सॉल्यूशन ये नहीं है कि ये अभी k की वैल्यू निकालनी पेंडिंग नहीं है k की वैल्यू हम निकाल चुके हैं सो यू कैन से k इज ऑल रियल्स ये रियल्स का सिंबल है k बिलोंग्स टू ऑल रियल्स एक्सेप्ट k इज इक्वल टू 1 सो दिस इज आवर आंसर दैट व्हेन द सिस्टम इज हैविंग यूनिक सॉल्यूशन अब ये सॉल्यूशन हमने निकाल के दिखाया कि अच्छा सॉल्यूशन होगा अब वो सॉल्यूशन क्या होगा वो हमने इसको जनरल निकाल के दिखाया है ये ऑप्शनल स्टेप था ये आपको बोला जाए आप तभी करोगे कि इन इफ देयर इज अ यूनिक सॉल्यूशन देन फाइंड इट तो फाइंड करने के लिए हमने उसको के की टर्म्स में निकाल दिया है बट अगर आपको इसके बाद अब के की मैं एक पर्टिकुलर वैल्यू दे दूं से के इज इक्वल टू 2 सो आप सिस्टम को बिल्कुल स्टार्टिंग से सॉल्व कर सकते हो आप ओरिजिनल मैट्रिक्स में के को 2 पुट कर दो या फिर जनरल सॉल्यूशन आपने निकाल लिया है एक्स और वाई की वैल्यू अब यहाँ पे k को 2 डालो 3 डालो 1/2 डालो व्हाटएवर एनीथिंग एक्सेप्ट 1 यू विल गेट सम वैल्यूज ऑफ x एंड y तो यहाँ से फर्दर कोई कंडीशन नहीं आने वाली है ये आपके x और y की वैल्यूज हैं कि ये सॉल्यूशन है
यही के अलग मेथड भी हो सकता है कि हम पहले ये वाला स्टेप कर लें फिर हम देखें कि डिनोमिनेटर जीरो नहीं होना चाहिए तो उससे हम कंडीशन निकाल लेंगे
यस यस यू कैन डू दैट दैट वे आल्सो मैंने इसीलिए ये स्टेप लास्ट में किया है बिकॉज ये ऑप्शनल था आपको ये वाला जो यहाँ पे कन्वीनियंट इस तरह के क्वेश्चंस के लिए यहाँ पे जीरो कब होगी ये वैल्यू ये वाला प्रोसेस ज्यादा कन्वीनियंट होता है क्योंकि हो सकता है वहीं से आ जाए कि यूनिक सॉल्यूशन हो ही नहीं सकता कुछ ऐसा क्वेश्चन हो उसमें यूनिक सॉल्यूशन आए ना तो फालतू में हमारा रीएफ बनाने का ट्राई करे बट वो बने ना मीन्स आई होप यू आर गेटिंग माई पॉइंट आप उसको मिनिमल कैलकुलेशन से आंसर कर दो ये होगा बट उसके बाद फिर अगर आपको पता चल गया अच्छा है सॉल्यूशन देन यू कंटिन्यू योर कैलकुलेशन बट अदरवाइज इट्स कम्प्लीटली फाइन. आप डायरेक्टली वो बिल्कुल लास्ट तक करना चाहते हो, उसके बाद डिनोमिनेटर से कंडीशन निकालना चाहते हो, फिर आप यहीं से कंडीशन निकाल सकते हो कि इफ के इज वन देन क्लियरली एक्स एंड वाई डू नॉट एग्जिस्ट बिकॉज यू सी राइट k is equal to 1, then x and y do not exist. So in that case, there is no solution. But I am telling you, us technique mein ek risk hota hai because even differential equations mein bhi aise question aate the ki hum jaise if you remember hum Fourier series mein nikalte the, right? An. An mein suppose niche n minus 1 ka square aa gaya, tab hum bol dete the ki acha ye wala n not equals to 1 ke liye hai. फिर n इज इक्वल टू वन के लिए हम अलग से निकालते थे, तो वो आ भी सकता था जीरो या वो नहीं भी आ सकता है. सेम इज हियर के नॉट इक्वल्स टू वन के लिए तो आपको पता चल गया कि ये है, बट k इज इक्वल टू वन के लिए क्या सॉल्यूशन होगा कि नहीं होगा, सो दैट रिमेन्स अनआंसर्ड. दैट इज वाई. तो इसलिए वो जो जैसे मैंने बताया है आप वैसे कंक्लूड करोगे, सो दैट वुड बी बेटर.
तो हम इस इक्वेशन से हम बस यूनिक है कि नहीं वो कर सकते हैं, इनफाइनाइट और नो सॉल्यूशन वाली कंडीशन हम इससे नहीं कर सकते.
नहीं पता चलेगी आपको. हाँ
ओके,
मींस पता चल सकती है बट वो लिटिल बिट एलजेब्रा इज रिक्वायर्ड, थोड़ा सा आपको कैलकुलेशंस, मतलब आपको बस कंडीशंस पता होनी चाहिए कि रैंक कैसे देखना है, अदर देन यू विल बी एबल टू डू.
ओके मैम. एंड मैम वो जीरो में आपने कहा था रैंक जीरो नहीं हो सकता, मैम वो उसका रीजन क्या था मैम?
रैंक जीरो कब होगा? आप रैंक जीरो, आप रैंक की डेफिनेशन बताओ मुझे. देखो रैंक की डेफिनेशन है द नंबर ऑफ नॉन जीरो रोज इन अ मैट्रिक्स आफ्टर कन्वर्टिंग इनटू आरआरईएफ, राइट? तो सपोज आपने किसी भी मैट्रिक्स को उसकी रो रिड्यूस्ड एशलन फॉर्म में कन्वर्ट किया, तो उसकी रो रिड्यूस्ड एशलन फॉर्म क्या कभी ये हो सकती है? यू टेल मी, इज इट पॉसिबल? रो रिड्यूस्ड एशलन फॉर्म में तो हमेशा यहाँ वन बनाते हैं, यहाँ पे भी वन बनाते हैं, यहाँ पे भी, इट्स ऑलवेज डायगोनल एंट्रीज पे वन बनाते हैं. तो ये हो जाता है कई बार कि थर्ड रो में ऑटोमेटिकली वो ऑपरेशन बनाते हुए जीरो बन गया, या सेकेंड रो भी जीरो बन गई, बट द फर्स्ट एंट्री इज ऑलवेज अंडर कंट्रोल. यू रिमेम्बर, इसको तो हम हमेशा वन बनाते हैं. सो देर इज नो पॉसिबिलिटी फॉर यू कि जो आपको सिस्टम ऑफ इक्वेशंस मिला है सॉल्व करने के लिए उसको आपने कन्वर्ट किया रो रिड्यूस्ड एशलन फॉर्म में और सारी की सारी रोज ही जीरो बन गई. सारी की सारी रोज जीरो बनने का क्या मतलब है? कि आपका सिस्टम ये है, कुछ भी हो राइट साइड पे, कुछ भी लिख सकते हैं. तो ये तो इट्स मीनिंगलेस, राइट? हाउ द जीरो कैन बी कंपेयर्ड विद नॉन जीरो नंबर? सो ये मीनिंगलेस सिस्टम्स हैं. वी आर नॉट सीकिंग सॉल्यूशंस फॉर दीज काइंड ऑफ सिस्टम्स. दैट इज व्हाई रैंक जीरो कुछ चीजें देखो सिर्फ मैथमेटिकली थ्योरीज को कंप्लीट करने के लिए डिफाइंड होती हैं कि रैंक जीरो का मतलब क्या होगा, बट रैंक जीरो फिजिकली डज नॉट मीन एनीथिंग. ओके, सो दैट्स व्हाई जो भी हमें ये सिस्टम मिलेंगे सॉल्व करने के लिए हम उनके नॉन जीरो सॉल्यूशंस ढूंढ रहे हैं. यू विल नेवर एवर हैव दिस रैंक जीरो केस अराइजिंग. एटलीस्ट उसका फर्स्ट रो तो नॉन जीरो रो में सर्वाइव करेगा ही करेगा, बाकी पूरी मैट्रिक्स जीरो बन भी जाए बिकॉज हम सबसे पहले इस एंट्री को वन बनाते हैं तो वो हमेशा सर्वाइव करेगा ही करेगा.
पर सपोज अगर पहले कॉलम में हमें दिया ही 000 हुआ है मैम पहले कॉलम में, बाकी सब तो फिर उसको वन कैसे बनाएंगे?
कैसे पहले कॉलम है? वो तो फिर वेरिएबल ही ना एग्जिस्ट करता. अगर पहला कॉलम जीरो होने का मतलब है कि आपका सपोज सिस्टम ऑफ इक्वेशन ऐसे है, जीरो इंटू एक्स प्लस टू इंटू वाई प्लस थ्री इंटू जेड इज फाइव, जीरो इंटू एक्स माइनस वाई माइनस जेड इज एट, जीरो इंटू एक्स प्लस वाई प्लस जेड इज थ्री. तो एक्स तो है ही नहीं ना, फिर इसको छोड़ दो, फिर मैट्रिक्स ही यहाँ से स्टार्ट हो रही है. तो वो फिर पहला कॉलम जीरो होने का मतलब है वो वेरिएबल ही नहीं है. दैट मींस आपके सिस्टम में ही दो वेरिएबल्स है, तो मैट्रिक्स ही यहां से स्टार्ट होगी इन दैट के साथ.
यस मैम. ओके मैम.
और ये हाँ, और ये भी हो सकता है कि इस तरह का सिस्टम हो जीरो टू वन. तो व्हाट वी कैन डू, अगर ये वाली सबसे पहली एंट्री, ये जनरल है किसी भी क्वेश्चन के लिए होगा, अगर आपको ऐसा सिस्टम मिलता है जिसमें फर्स्ट इक्वेशन में फर्स्ट वेरिएबल मिसिंग है, दूसरी दो में है बट फर्स्ट में मिसिंग है, तो आप रो इंटरचेंज कर लो. ऑलवेज फर्स्ट मेक दिस वन एंड देन यू स्टार्ट योर प्रोसीजर ऑफ कन्वर्टिंग इनटू आरआरईएफ.
इचा मैम.
यस.
ओके. यस सर, सॉरी, टाइम इज डन. ओके, आई विल टेक रेस्ट ऑफ योर डाउट्स नेक्स्ट टाइम. थैंक यू.